బ్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్రవేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర, హూ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సర్వజ్ఞ సర్వవిత సర్వశక్తిమాన్, bestow all kinds of prosperity, wealth, health and eternal happiness with paripurna lakshmi katakshams to you and entire your family members and your friends too. Let us begin Bhagavadgeeta verse number 6 of 10th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Maharshaya Sapta Purve Chatvaro Manavastatha Madbhava Manasa Jataha యేషాం లోక ఇమాః ప్రజాః. As we saw in the last episode, the Bhagavan is just exploring his glories as the antara prapancha in the last two verses. Verse number 4 and 5, they introduced antara prapancha srishtihi. So when God created the world, so the first creation is the subtle world antara prapancham. Then the gross world bahya prapancham also is created by the Ishvara. How? Creating four rishis first with his manasa sankalpa, just he thought of creating. So when he thought, that thinking about something is known as sankalpa. The sankalpa means what? So, to think, to begin something. Okay, let me join in the new job, new company. Or let me get married. Let me get children. Let me get introduced to new people. That all these things are known as sankalpa. So, life is based on sankalpa shakti. Therefore, sankalpa prabhavan kaman sarvan parthamanogatan. So, this sankalpa prabhavan kaman means all the desires which are born out of sankalpa. Sankalpa becomes the base. Now, this entire srishti had only because of sankalpa, one sankalpa of Brahmaji. Brahmaji thought of creating the world, suddenly he got four rishis. As I told you in the last session, the four rishis were sent to have knowledge from Lord Shiva, who is in the form of Dakshinamurti, but he thought about Maunam. Many people are not understanding Maunam means what. Maunam means people are saying that observing silence. The observance of silence is not Maunam in the meaning of Dakshinamurti Tattva. Dakshinamurti means a deity who is facing the south. South facing deity is known as Dakshinamurti. Dakshina Abhimukha Murti Esya. That deity, when it faces the direction south, you can find four rishis. He taught all the knowledge in the language of Maunam. This is what understanding. He didn't open the mouth. He without, because he is Ishvara, without opening the mouth, he can teach. That's the common meaning every one of us aware. But the special meaning, he thought about Maunam means about para prakriti, which is beyond the world. So once you understand, you become Maunam. That's what the meaning. So when he thought para prakriti and these four rishis, they adapted Nivritti Marga. Nivritti Marga means what? A marga, a path through which one can get liberation, mokshaha. Therefore, they have become meditators all the time. You can see everywhere where the Dakshinamurti is available under that four deities. Four, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumara, Sanatana. There's all these four rishis who were the first created Manushya, who become rishis. Then there are seven rishis created afterwards. So when they became adapted Nivritti Marga, this Brahmaji became little bit angry. Then through this Brahmaji's eyes, there were 11 people originated called 11 Rudras. Ekadasha Rudraha. Okay. Rudraha means the tears of the eyes. It's known as Ekadasha Rudraha. You can find in the Puranas. Then he thought of creating rishis. Rishis were not sannyasis. Actually, they adopt the grihastha life and slightly equal to vanaprastha life. They have family, wife, children and everything. There were seven rishis who were created by Brahmaji. And Purve Chatvaraha Rishayaha, then Sapta Maharishayaha. There are seven rishis. So the seven rishis are listed in different places with different name. So, we can name them Atri, Bhagu, Kutsa, Vasishta, Kashyapa, Gautama, Angirasa Maharishis. These seven Maharishis who were created by Brahmaji. Then also he created 14 Manus. This Manu become the authoritative originate for Manushyaha, Manavaha. These 14 Manus, they have each one of them their own duration of lifetime. So every Manu year, their age is known as Manvantaram. One Manu's Manvantaram contains 71 Chaturyugas. We saw the calculation in the previous chapters. So these four Yugas are containing particular being time. These Chatur Yugas become one Yuga for them. Now 71 Chatur Yugas, 14 into 71 is equal to one day of our Brahmaji. Now we are undergoing the Manu, name of him is Vaivasvata Manu. Therefore we say it, Adya Brahmanaha Dvitiye Parardhe Vaivasvata Manvantare Ashtavimshati Tame Kali Yuge Prathame Pade Jambhadvipe Bharata Varushe Bharata Khande Meroho Dakshine Parshve Dhandakaranyake. So this, the Sankalpa has derived. Now we can understand why we name all the sankalpas of this Manu etc. Because we are the lineage of Manus. The Bharata, the India has got, or the world has got, creation has got only two paramparas. One parampara which is known as Rishi Parampara. Another parampara which is known as Grihastha Parampara. So Rishi Parampara and the Grihastha Rishi Parampara. So one is known as Nivritti Parampara, another is known as Pravritti Parampara. This Pravritti Parampara has got a Gotra. Every Rishi become the elder of a Gotra. Therefore, that particular Rishi's lineage is called by his own name. Therefore, we have got Kashyapa Gotra, Vasishtha Gotra, Bhrigu Gotra, Atri Gotra. And certain time there are branches of Vishwamitra Gotra. So these rishis are considered the followers of those rishis alone. When we go to temple, we are asked name, nakshatra, rashi and gotra. Sometimes, you know, people say Bharatvaja Gotra, Shiva Gotra. So all these gotras, they are connected with these seven rishis. We are Rishi Parampara. Now you could understand why our Sanatana Dharma always talks about Rishis, Munis, because they are our forefathers. We are lineage of those great souls Therefore, we also have the rights and power, capacity to become rishis, to dig world in different manner. Digging inside, we will be exploring outside too. It is a unique method. Now, four rishis and seven maharishis and 14 manus have been created. All of them are called manasa jataha, manasa putraha. So all of them are because of my own sankalpa. Now you can understand the birth of Bhagavan, the birth of this rishis, everything is unique. This is sankalpa matrena. Now srishti means what? Based on sankalpa. That is the secret explored, expressed and unfolded by Lord in this verse. You can just note it down. Your sankalpa will create your born world. Because Ishwaratvam is there in us. Everything is Ishwara alone. Therefore, be careful with your sankalpa. The sankalpa should not be influenced by any other outside sources. We should be very much focused when we have sankalpa. The thought patterns are very important. Even in Yoga Sutra, Bhagavan Patanjali says, organizing this thought pattern alone is known as yoga. Chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga means what? So reorganizing thought pattern. Sankalpa becomes the cause of our future. Sankalpa is creating the world. Sankalpa created the world. Till now, everything is because of sankalpa. Your sankalpa has created your life. My sankalpa have created my life. Therefore, we should be very careful with sankalpa. Therefore, artificially, purposely we do sankalpa before every puja so that I can have positive sankalpa with a determination in the sannidhya of Ishvara. Every temple, the puja is began with sankalpa, that sankalpa which is endowed with welfare of entire creatures. Our rishis had the sankalpa in the form of prayer. Bhadram karune bhishrunayama devaha bhadram pashye makshabhir yajatraha sthirai rangai istushtvagum sastanubhihi vyashema devahi tanyadayuhum swastina indro vriddhashravaha swastina pusha vishvavedaha swasti nastarkshyo arishtanimihim swasti no brihaspatir dadhatu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Sankalpa, pure sankalpa, which is in the form of prayer. That's what the glory of our invention as the spiritual path. This spiritual construction because of our forefathers' blessings. We should be very thankful to them. He says, all of them are manasa jataha madbhavaha. This madbhavaha, Acharya says, madgata bhavana vaishnavena samarthyena upetaha. Who possess my nature? Now you see, God has created beings equal to Him. Now also that is the fact. We are not able to understand it. We are making effort to that. Yesham loke ima prajaha. They have become many people of this srishti now. Next verse. Yetam vibhotim yogancha mama yovyeti tattvataha sovi kampena yogena yujyate natra samshayaha. Within one shloka, Bhagavan has narrated about Bahya Prapancha. Every text it explores in different way. తైత్రి ఉపనిషత్ సేస్ బాహ్య ప్రపంచ తస్మాద్ ఏ తస్మాద్ ఆత్మన ఆకాశ సంభూత ఆకాశాద్ వాయు వాయోరగ్ని అగ్నేరాప అద్భ్య పృథివీ పృథివ్యామోషధయ ఓషధిభ్యోన్నం అన్నాత్ పురుష. ఇట్ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ ద సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫైవ్ ఎలిమెంటల్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్, బట్ హియర్ హీ జస్ట్ గేవ్ అ సాలిడ్ ఐడియా సో దట్ వీ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్. సో ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ బిగన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సంకల్ప. ద సైన్స్ షుడ్ అక్సెప్ట్ ఇట్. Nowadays, you know, scientists, especially Indian scientists, they are more aware. They are, any scientist, I consider they are rishis, because they can see what we cannot see. They can think what we cannot think. They can reach where we cannot reach. So they are the, you know, the people who are taking us to the next level, next level, next level. If they are little bit having the knowledge about the scriptural aspects, it would be mind-blowing. You know, great future in future. Okay. So now Bhagavan says, Yetam vibhutim yogam cha. My both glories, if you understand, if anybody understands, they will get liberated. What is the both glories? Antra prapancha. That is known as Karana Prapancha. Bahya Prapancha, Karya Prapancha. So both glories, if a person understands in proper way how it has to be understood, then he becomes a person who is liberated. Nothing can shake him. Avikampena Yogena Yujyate. He becomes an eligible person to go to next level. What is the next level? Arupa Bhakti. Then there we call it Advaita Rupa Ishwaraha, Vivarta Upadana Karana Ishwaraha. That's what which we are going to explore after 13th chapter. Now one should understand these both glories. Just within three verses, Bhagavan has revealed us. Now we got an idea. Okay, this antara prapancha, inner world, is created by God. Then this outer world also created by God. So what? So what means what? That's all, the matter is completed. But we got the knowledge, but there is no prayojana. What is the benefit by knowing this? You should know the inner core of it, tattvataha. That's what he says, tattvataha yaha veti, one who understands how it has to be understood in the way so that you could assimilate. By assimilation you will find the prayojana, means freedom in your life. That will begin from the next words. We call it Virat Bhaktihi or Virat Bhaktaha. That we will continue from the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. హరి ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. హరి ఓం. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ.